How's it going? Good to see you again. As always, I'm the host of MouseKingdomVlog, William O'Brien. Now, let me tell you what's going to happen for this new installment of MKV. Well, the stories are, there's going to be a cool experience at D23 called Disney's Broadway and Beyond. Now, I could be wrong about the title, but you'll find out in just a second. I'll be talking about a new game for Xbox One called Fantasia. It looks really cool, and I'll even show you the new trailer for it. Then I'll be talking about my Star Wars Weekend experience. That was a lot of fun also, and what else? Oh yeah, I'll be talking about the Wilderness Explorers experience at Animal Kingdom. So, let's get started. So here's the first story. I know I don't talk about the D23 Expo a lot. Actually, I never talked about it before. But anyway, this story was sent in by my girlfriend slash producer of MouseKingdomVlog, Amanda Ford. So here we go. According to a press release issued by the Walt Disney Company, Thomas Schumacher will host this host a musical journey into Disney's history on Broadway and beyond at the D23 Expo, the ultimate Disney fan event. The performance will feature an all-star lineup, including Honey Blickenstaff, who played in The Little Mermaid, Ashley Brown, who played in Mary Poppins and Beauty and the Beast, Merlee Dandridge, Tarzan and Naiada, Josh Strickland, Tarzan, and Alton Fitzgerald White, The Lion King, who will sing beloved songs from the award-winning musicals they starred in, as well as classic tunes from the Disney on Broadway catalog. The one-night-only performance will take place on Friday, August 9th, 2013, at 6:30 p.m. on Stage 23 inside the Anaheim Convention. Now, time for her opinion, Amanda's opinion. This musical performance is sure to be the perfect tribute to some of Disney's most loved and most successful past productions. The cast couldn't get any bigger, and I know there will be a ton of support for the show. I don't know if one night will be enough, but I'm sure it's tough to get all those stars together. And if you miss this one, you can always go see Aladdin this fall. Thank you, Amanda. You're absolutely right. I don't think one night is enough. But I'll tell you one thing. When a video surfaces of this performance, I will definitely put it on my Facebook page and maybe link it to this video in the future. Or future video. I'll work out the kinks. Let's move on. So, Xbox One. First of all, I don't know why they're calling it Xbox One, because it's the third Xbox. But anyway, it's debuting a new game from Disney called Fantasia. And yes, the same name of the original movie with integrating animation with music and different styles of animation. And it looks really cool, and I wish I had an Xbox One, but how about you take a look?
Swimming in your world, something spiritual. I'm gonna get every time you spend the
want an Xbox One even more now. It looks like you can control the music with your hands and movements and what do you think about Disney putting in today's music with this new game, Bruno Mars, Locked Out of Heaven, and other some of today's music. I even think Bohemian Rhapsody might be in there too. But don't worry, they're also going to be integrating some classic music too, especially from Fantasia. You can't have a Fantasia game without having Fantasia music in it. So what do you think? Let me know down in the comment section. I'll get to it later. What's next? So I had a great time at Star Wars Weekends with my good friend Micah. Actually, I posted up a video called MKV's Midway Mania Adventure. It's a four-part video. They're all short. I'll link it in the video at the end. Link the video at the end of this episode. It has nothing to do with Star Wars Weekends. But anyway, Star Wars Weekends was really, really, really fun. Just getting to see the characters and stuff, and I'll post the pictures on our Facebook page. Wait a minute, what's happening?
This is Darth Vader of the Sith. I have taken over his transmission because he is Rebel Scum. So you will stop watching his vlog, or else you will feel the consequences of the Force.
Is he gone? Good. It's good. So, where was I? Oh yeah, I wanted to show you kind of a quick video clip of one of the cool shows. Even though I wasn't, you know, picked for it, and it's been really awesome, it's called Behind the Force. And here's what it is.
Tales from the Clone Wars. Early in the conflict, the Jedi Knights struck an alliance with the vile gangsters of the High Criminal Empire in order to secure an advantage against the evil Separatist forces. To maintain this treaty, the Jedi Council dispatches Obi-Wan Kenobi and Ahsoka Tano to the distant planet Tatooine for an audience with the powerful gangster Jabba the Hutt. Now, on the lonely windswept road that winds to the Iron Citadel of the Loathsome Criminal, the two Jedi make their way to an uncertain appointment.
I haven't been to Tatooine since Master Skywalker and I rescued Stinky.
I beg your pardon?
Stinky? That's what Anakin called Jabba's son, Rana. I got the impression Anakin isn't very fond of the Hutts.
Yes, well, perhaps that's why he opted out of this mission.
Maybe. But he usually prefers taking action over bookkeeping.
Sorry, did you say bookkeeping?
Yeah. Instead of coming with us, he's stuck reviewing stacks of intelligence reports with Senator Amidala.
With Padme? Really?
Yes. From the sounds of it, they're going to have to spend a whole week together working side by side to make any progress.
Curious. Tell me, Ahsoka, does Anakin take a lot of these missions with Padme?
Really? I say he visits the Supreme Chancellor more often than Senator Amidala, but who's counting, right?
I still gotta meet one of a voice actor that I really look up to, called, his name is James Arnold Taylor. I gotta meet him for a quick second. That's still cool. I was a little awestruck by it, but yeah. I can't wait till next year, and I'll definitely show you what's going on if we're, MKV is on for another year, hopefully more than 1 year. It's all up to you. Let's move on to the last story. So at Disney's Animal Kingdom, there is a new experience. So rather than just blabbering about it, I'll send it to my little friends, Amelia and Tommy. Take it away, guys.
Hi, I'm Amelia.
And I'm her brother, Tommy.
We're at Disney's Animal Kingdom in Florida. to play the new Wilderness Explorers experience.
Like in the Disney Pixar movie Up.
An explorer is a friend to all, be it plants or fish or a tiny mole.
You learn the Wilderness Explorer call and earn the first badge sticker for your handbook.
The wilderness must be explored. Come, come, roar! A great job.
As you explore Disney's Animal Kingdom, there are more than 30 activities to earn badge stickers for your Wilderness Explorer handbook.
What kind of stuff are we going to do to earn our badge stickers?
You're going to dig for fossils, look for flamingos, bugs, and gorillas, and learn about conservation and the natural world all around us. Are you ready to explore?
Does anyone know why flamingos turn pink?
Because they eat shrimp?
Because they eat shrimp, exactly right.
Lots of people in Disney's Animal Kingdom are wilderness explorers.
You can tell because they know the pledge.
The wilderness must be explored. Call, call.
Yeah, good job.
Save your handbook so if you don't earn all the badges in one day, you can get more on your next adventure. Get all the badges and you'll be a senior wilderness explorer. We have 5 badges so far, so we are tadpoles.
After lunch, I want to get the hiking badge. Bye!
Now, the cool thing about this experience is, well, you don't have to be a kid to do it. You can actually be a kid of any age, from 1 to 101. And I'm hoping to actually get the badges. Stickers, but you know what I mean. If you had the chance, would you do it? If so, how many badges would you get? Let me know down in the comment section and I'll get back to it. Well, let's wrap it up. Hey, thanks for sticking around for the newest installment of Mouse Kingdom Vlog, episode 12. Not 13, 12. I still can't believe I did that, but anyway. I think I finally got into a rhythm of the videos, integrating the videos, and how the stories, you know, run and how smoothly the transitions are. I think it's going to make it a lot better. Now, next Saturday will be my last episode for a while because if you haven't seen the newest inside look, I told you, the viewers, that I will be having mouth surgery the 27th, which is really soon. But don't worry, I'll be fine. Going down to Shannon's Gainesville, it's another really good down there, and make a smooth recovery. But until then, before I fully recover and can make episodes again, hopefully I can get my team members rounded up to record videos for me and about the stories and stuff, and I'll edit them with the videos and how the episodes have been recently. What else? I think that's it. So, please follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/MouseKingdomVlog. And also, you can follow us on Twitter at MKingdomVlog. Now you can see the other videos, the other inside looks, the other random videos. All you do is hit that MouseKingdomVlog icon in the corner. Now, if you want to subscribe to us, you can just hit that button right there. And if you want to see the Mouse Kingdom Vlogs Midway Mania Adventure, that's a mouthful, just hit that button right there. Well, it says Mouse Kingdom Vlog Midway Mania, actually MKV, but you know what I mean. So, well, have a great week. And always remember, if you can dream it, you can definitely do it. Bye!